Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Kevil, and welcome back to the Craftadia server. Today, we are starting out at my little AFK hut that is over near our crops. I was AFKing these, just came through and collected them. So we have plenty of paper, finally, to where we got our first set of rockets with our elytra. We are finally able to fly and get some stuff done here on the server. So today, I want to start out with a 1 hour mining time lapse. That is how we ended last episode. However, I'm already out of coal, so I need to go through and get a ton of resources. So before we start out with that 1 hour time lapse, I do want to discuss a little bit of our plans for the season. So if I take a quick flight up and land on top of the skeleton of Market, you can see that I kind of started outlining my plot. And there is still an issue with Optifine. Optifine 1.17.1 doesn't have lazy chunk loading, which means that as I fly away from chunks, the server unloads them and Optifine doesn't keep them pseudo loaded. So it is super frustrating not being able to see everything loaded like I would like it to be. Hopefully that will get fixed in the future. So I'm sorry for the short render distance. I hate it as much as you do. And then there's one more challenge that I'm trying to give myself for this season. I'm going to do a little bit of terraforming here and there, but mostly I want to keep as much of the natural generation as possible, because last season I came through and I was in a hilly savanna and I just completely mined the entire thing down to sea level. And I kind of regret doing that. I should have built using the terrain I was given instead of just flattening the whole thing. So this season, we're not going to flatten anything. We're going to try to build using the terrain as it spawned. Of course, you know, some terraforming to make pathways and waterfalls and such. But one thing that I will be doing, changing the terrain, is this whole lake is going to get a lot deeper, but I'm going to probably keep it the same size as it is now. I'm going to create an island in the center, and that's where my fishing hut's going to be. But with all that planning aside, it is time to do our 1 hour time lapse. Alright guys, here is the final tower of everything that we collected. Couple diamonds there in the middle. Overall, it wasn't that lucky of a diamond trip, but we got plenty of coal and iron. So let's mine this whole thing up with some Fortune 4, since this is the Craftadia server and it's lightly modded. And let's see how many resources we get. Here is our final collection. And honestly, I'm a little disappointed. We spent about 40 minutes mining and we only found 37 diamonds, which is it's an acceptable amount. And then not that much gold at all, only a little bit of iron and copper. But our main goal was to get coal so we can run our furnaces. And then we did spend about 20 minutes gathering mud. So this will be useful for us to farm some of those new custom crops over here. So yeah, I'm overall happy. We got a Riptide 1 book and our first name tag, and then we also got our first pumpkin, melons, and beetroot seeds. So I think we have every crop at this point, so I am pretty happy with that. I'm gonna get some work done around the base, and then we're gonna get some building done. So I'll catch up with you guys in a few minutes. All right, so I did a little bit of planning, and basically I want some manual above ground farms over in this area. And that's going to include wheat, melons, pumpkins, and sugarcane, along with carrots, potatoes, beetroots, and cocoa beans. This will all be above ground in an area over beyond these trees. And then below that, I'm going to have some automatic farms, including melons, pumpkins, and sugarcane. And then also, I think I'm going to do manual chorus below ground, just because it doesn't look good above ground. It doesn't fit the theme at all. So that's gonna go below ground for sure. All right, guys, it has been 3 days since I was last on the server. I am feeling a lot better, so hopefully no more sick voice. But before I left for work, I actually started digging this hole, and while I was gone, it has sprung up and filled up with some water, which is nice. Hopefully this will fill all the way to the top, and then it has started cutting out a river, but the river dried up because this big hole appeared. So I actually have a giant ravine under my claim that I didn't notice until coming back and like, why'd the river all dry up? It's because it just, the floor broke out from the river. So that's not good. I'm going to have to fix that here and, you know, dig out this river, flush it out a little bit more and make it look nice and pretty. And of course, patch this hole that just appeared. I also did claim this one chunk right here, where this chunk here isn't actually claimed by me. And that's because if we drop down the hole that I made where all this water is coming from, but if we look over here, there is a geode. So this is the only geode that I've seen on my claim yet, so that's why I claimed it. If I find a better one, I will unclaim this one. But I'm thinking this would be a nice one to just have with the rest of my farms. There's a spider spawner over here that's part of my claim, so I could kill spiders and also collect geodes at the same time. So I might mine this out and leave the budding geodes or whatever they're called, so that way we can, you know, farm these, which I think would be pretty cool. I don't really know what uses there are for these besides the spyglass. Can you make blocks out of them? Can you make these blocks out of those? Because I guess that would be cool. Also, I'd like to announce that we will be doing a giveaway on the channel soon for these items here. Maybe more if I get more items between now and the giveaway, but that won't be this episode. Just look forward to it. So right now I'm playing around with the design for my nature area over here, and I think I'm gonna create a dome for my bees to be inside of, and I kind of like this idea of doing a large dome over in this corner right here, but I don't know how I feel about this. I'm going for a 2-block center. I might actually make this become a 1-block center, and I think I'll like it a lot better, and I might actually make this a bit smaller. I think I am going too large. My chunk border is here. I do need to save room to put greens all around this fence post, or leaves, I mean. So I do need to actually downsize this slightly, but this is kind of the idea I'm going for over in my, you know, nature area. We'll have all of our farms over here in this area, but I thought bees in the corner sound pretty good. Some bees in the trap, you know what I mean. All right, after some adjustments, I am happy with this iteration of the trussle or fencing, whatever you want to call it, and it's actually going to make me move where this pond is going to be, because I do want it to come down where it currently is. So imagine for a second these fully covered in leaves. So they will have really thick leaves surrounding them. You probably won't even be able to see the fencing anymore. And then there's going to be glass that goes from between the leaves in each of the four sides. So nothing will be able to come in or out other than a door that'll be somewhere. And this will be full of, you know, it'll have a nice, beautiful tree, some water, a bunch of flowers, and a couple of bees floating around. And then underground somewhere will be the actual AFKable bee farm. So nice, pretty thing on top and the AFK farm down below. And I'm actually really excited for how this is going to look. So I'm going to get some work done on this and I'll let you guys know how it turns out. All right, I do want to update you guys with market progress in this episode, and disclaimer, I take zero credit for any of the building that has been done so far. This is completely Listerwork, Mama Bear, and his family who have placed every block in here, and they're doing an amazing job. I am so grateful for them. They are just doing this for free. Well, not for free. Obviously, they are members of Market, and they love doing this stuff, so I appreciate them so much. But holy crap, the progress that they have accomplished in this the last few days has been incredible. So if we come up the bubble elevator, this brings us to the second floor, and it is coming along beautifully. As of what you see on camera right now, none of this was from me, so thank you very much. You guys are amazing, and let's get back to building my apiary. Well, despite the rain making things a bit more ugly, we have finished our area for our bees to reside in. I actually really, really like the hanging glow leaves. There may be a bit too many of them, in my opinion, but they are providing almost all the light for this build, so no mobs can spawn. And overall, I think it looks nice. There's plenty of flower options for the bees to come and interact with. The bees can actually use these as sources of pollen. So I'm going to put in about 6 bees up here, I think. So the farm that I'm going to be using is outdated. It is back from Waddles when 1.15 was released over a year ago. And it definitely is outdated, and the redstone could be better, I believe. However, it does the job that I need it to. So that's the one that I'm going to go with. Oh, there we go. Breed and make a baby. Oh, you are a 3-stack. Is this one going to come out? We got baby bee. Yeah, there's one more in there, so we can breed again. Hello. So nice, I have all 6 bees up here that I want at this point. Perfect. All right, as the sun sets, our little honey hives are finished. So these 2 hives behind me have 3 bees in each of them and will be producing us honey nonstop as long as I keep it full of glass bottles. So we don't have huge uses for honey on the server. There are some farms that I need to make that require honey blocks, so that's why we set up this farm. And then down here where my secret laboratory is, the entrance that I showed earlier, that's where we will have a much larger scale farm for making beeswax. So I'm excited for that, and we will do that in a future episode, maybe not next episode, but we will get that soon because we do need the wax for copper blocks. But as of now, we have our first honey bottle. Yes, okay, so I can replace this honey bottle here, and now we have a farm that is able to nonstop produce. So perfect. And then this one still hasn't produced a honey bottle for me yet, so I need to AFK for like 30 minutes, and then I will be able to have the farm fully AFKable. And my inventory is empty except for this dripstone block, because I am going to AFK in here. I am 95% sure that a mob can't spawn in here, but I feel like if I stand in the center, it won't matter. Nothing can spawn in here. So I'm going to AFK for a little bit and then edit today's episode. I am going on vacation for a week, so for those of you who have stuck around until the end of the episode, this episode is coming out halfway through my vacation. Then I'll be back making big videos regularly. So yeah, I will see you guys in like a week and a half. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.